Hi everyone, welcome or welcome back to my channel. My name is Leanna. Today I'm going to be reviewing the new Anastasia Beverly Hills liquid foundation. It's their luminous foundation. They did have another foundation that came out a few years ago and it was a stick foundation. It was supposed to be matte. So this is their first liquid foundation and it's their first luminous foundation. It is $50 Canadian and you get 1.01 fluid ounces. So that's about the standard amount. It does come in 50 different shades. I will put up a little shade chart here so you can see the different shades. I believe there is a fair, light, medium, tan, and deep category. And the shade that I'm going to be doing different wear tests with is with 110C. Now, that is what I was shade matched with on the app. It's what the woman at Sephora shade matched me to while I was there. It is the second lightest shade. I think I personally would have gone with 100 neutral. They did not have a tester for that in store. And in fact, a lot of the testers there were just simply missing. It didn't look like they had the full range to begin with, which is a little odd. At my Sephora, we do tend to have full foundation collections there. So I did find that a little strange. I'm not really sure what was happening there, and usually the testers, there's not that many missing, so it's really inconvenient if you want to try and find your shade. Most of them were gone, and so you'd either have to buy one and try it yourself or look for it on another day. I would say there were a couple of paler shades and some of the medium shades. I didn't see very many deep shades. And this is a recurring thing that I was hearing about the launch at Ulta. They were not carrying all 50 shades, which apparently is very odd as well for Ulta. We don't have Ulta in Canada, so I can't really say, but just from hearing other people speak, they were finding that to be really strange. And again, most of the deep shades were the ones that were getting left out. So it's really not cool to have to be the one shade category where you're having to guess your shade and just buy it online. If you're going to do that, like, you need to make sure that at least a couple shades from each category are there if you can't carry all 50 of them. That's what I think. Anyway, this is a water-resistant liquid foundation that creates a luminous natural finish and is long-wearing even without setting power. Setting powder. It is supposed to be a self-setting foundation. It's supposed to have medium coverage and natural finish for normal, dry, combination, and oily skin types. I did not see sensitive skin listed. This is free from parabens and mineral oil. It's also vegan, cruelty-free, and gluten-free. I believe it's oil-free. It didn't say that on the Sephora app, but I've heard other people say that. This is a luminous foundation that blurs any imperfections, including discoloration and unevenness, without caking or masking the skin's natural radiance. The easy-to-blend formula goes on seamlessly and leaves the skin with a perfect-looking complexion, free of flashback or oxidization. So this is my third time wearing the foundation, not counting the time that she put it on my face at Sephora, so that would be four times. And so I've tried it a few different ways. I will show you some swatches first, get into the wear tests, and come back here and tell you what I think. So the two little ones on the bottom there, the top one is the e.l.f. Camo Concealer in Fair Warm. And then the one on the bottom is the Smashbox Concealer in Fair Neutral. And to the bigger swatches, the one on the top is the Hourglass Seamless Foundation Stick in Blanc. Then we have the Becca Ultimate Coverage Foundation in Porcelain, which I've never tried because look at it. The one below that is the Bisutang Aqualuster BB Cream in number 21, I think it is. And then the one right here is the Anastasia Beverly Hills Foundation in 110C. So hopefully you can see with these swatches that 110C is kind of a dark beige. Doesn't really look pink. We have a couple of pink swatches here. It's
It's kind of an odd one.
So I did get a little sample of the new ABH foundation, and she color matched me. Oh god, it's leaking. She color matched me to 110C, which is what it said on the Sephora app as well. So let's see. It does look a little bit dark. There's one shade before this that's 100N. A lot of the testers were missing while I was there. I'm just using a damp sponge today, and I'll probably set one side of my face. So this is like blending really well, and it has a really nice sort of natural finish to it. I have a feeling it's too dark for me. Which is why I'm kind of wearing it kind of sheerly right now, but I do have a feeling it's too dark. I can kind of tell just by looking at the shade that it's kind of a darker beige. It doesn't necessarily look super pink. It has like a beige undertone to it. Would have been nice if they'd had 100N there. I have a feeling that that probably would have been better. I mean, you can probably kind of see in the container maybe that it's kind of dark. I don't know. You probably won't be able to see under this light, but maybe when I go in natural light. Hopefully my concealer doesn't look too bright today. I think I'll color correct first just so that that doesn't happen. I'll set one side of my face with the e.l.f. HD powder. If anything, it might lighten it a little bit. And let's go into the natural light so you can see this up close.
And so this is going to be the side that I set with powder. And the side that I didn't. I think I can get away with this color just wearing it sheerly. I have a feeling if I went really heavy with it, I would look too dark right now. So I'm gonna have to be careful with the color, but right now it's looking really, really nice. So I'll come back in the evening and let you see how it looks.
I've filmed this twice now. I'm trying to see if I'm in focus. It's so hard. The mirror is too far away for me to tell. It looks like I am, but I don't know for sure. So hopefully, the third time is a charm. Hello. I've already checked in natural lighting, and I thought that you might want to see what it looks like under artificial lighting. So this is the side that I set with powder, and this is the side that I have not set. On this side, I am noticing a little bit more emphasis around the lines around my mouth here, but overall, things are looking really good. I'm not noticing any issues with my pores anywhere or any weird texture. it's not grabbing on to any weird dry patches. Not that I feel like I have any dry patches right now, but nowhere on my face is looking dry or scaly. Doesn't look too much like I'm wearing makeup, although I would say I can see it more than when I was wearing the Stellar foundation, which is the last one I tried. I did wipe a tissue on both sides of my face. I can't really see any transfer, which is good, but I can feel it a little bit when I touch my face. Not really on the side that I set, but on this side. But I feel like it looks good. I didn't notice too much of a shade discrepancy, but I'm probably going to try building it up and see if it looks too dark. So I'll come back and I'll try it a few different ways and see you again soon. Today is day 2 of the Anastasia Beverly Hills Foundation Wear Test. And today I'm going to be using a brush and again setting one side of my face. It's a pajama weekend, so don't mind me. I had 2 rounds of injections this week, as well as lowering medication again, so just having a pajama weekend. So I'm just going to put some foundation on my face, and then blend it out with a brush. And the brush I'm using today is the Real Techniques Expert Face Brush. And it seems to be blending with a brush just as easily as it does with a beauty sponge. I'm just going to blend near the eye area with a fingertip, since that's easier than using a brush. I didn't really take it near the eye area last time, but I want to try this time, so. I find a lot with like dewy and luminous foundations, you can tend to get brush strokes with them, but this isn't happening here, it's just blending really easily. Which is good, of course, because some people do prefer a brush over a sponge, or some people like to use a brush first and then use the sponge afterwards to blend everything out. And I feel like so far, it's looking like you could use either method and have it work equally well. I feel like it's looking a little darker today than it was the other time, so I did put a little bit more on today, and I feel like I can tell. The powder that I'm actually going to try today is a sample of the Laura Mercier translucent setting powder, because it was one of the only things available in the sample area that was remotely interesting when I placed an order from Sephora. I'll set the same side as the other day. And again, we'll go into the natural light and have a look. Here is the side that I set with powder. And then here's the side that I didn't set. Again, I'll be back towards the end of the day and show you how it looks. So here is what the foundation is looking like. This is the side that I set, and it looks pretty decently matte on this side. And I think you could put even more powder on and make it look pretty matte. And then this is the side that I didn't set. I'm still having these lines around here look a bit more emphasized. Otherwise, it looks about the same as it did the other day when I used the sponge instead of the brush. So, it looks comparable to what it did the other day. Not really having any issues again with dryness. Sometimes using a brush it can look a little bit more dry. I'm not finding that. The shade, though, is definitely not quite right. I feel it's a little bit too dark, and I feel as though it's an undertone issue as well. It's 110C. I'm assuming the C is for cool, but I feel like this is very warm. And I'm not sure if it's golden or something else, but it's definitely warm and just not looking quite right. It almost looks as though I bronzed my face, the entirety of my face today, and I didn't. I'm not wearing any other makeup except for base products, so that's it, and it just doesn't match. So I'm still going to try it one more day, and I'm going to put maybe two different primers, one on each side, and see how it looks. And after that, I will come back here and let you know what I think of the foundation. So today is the third wear test. I'm going to use some primer on my face today. This is the Wet n Wild Photo Focus Face Primer, which has some very similar ingredients in it to the foundation. So I'm going to put that sort of in the center of my face. And towards the outside, I'm just going to put a little bit of the L'Oreal Magic Lumi Light Diffusing Primer. That's just going to add a little bit of illumination towards the outside of my face. And I'm just going to use the sponge for the whole face. And usually if I notice any difference with a primer, it's going to be around my nose area. Oh goodness, put my concealer back in the tube and it squirts me in the face. Cool. So I think I'll just leave it as is today and not set either side of my face. So I'll just take you into the light and show you what it looks like. So I haven't set either side of my face. I did put a more mattifying primer in the center of my face and an illuminating primer towards the outer perimeter. And this is what it's looking like right now, and I'll come back again later and show you what it's looking like then. So in case you wanted to see it up close for today's wear test, you can see this is sort of like the main area where I put the mattifying sort of silicone-y primer, and then I did put a little bit of illuminating primer around the edges of my face. I am wearing a little bit of highlighter, not too much, and everything is looking really nice again. I actually noticed a little bit more of wear with the foundation today, even though I'm wearing the primers today. When I was blowing my nose, more of the foundation was coming off than without primer, which is, I don't know, I feel like that's kind of odd. Primer's supposed to help it stick down a little bit more, but I digress. No, it's supposed to be a natural finish, a luminous finish, and a medium coverage. I agree with that. I feel like it looks natural and it is a medium coverage. Could you build it up to full coverage? I'm not too sure about that. I feel like you could make it a little bit lighter coverage, but could you make it fuller? I'm not too sure that you could. I'd say medium coverage sounds right. It's definitely fuller coverage than the last foundation I tested, which was the Stellar Limitless foundation that was sheer to light. And this is definitely higher coverage from that. And because of that, you're going to see it a little bit more on your skin, but only if you really get very up close. I feel like if I'm just at, regular distance, I'm looking a couple feet away, I don't really see foundation on my skin. The shade is a little bit off. It's not so off that I'm constantly looking at myself and thinking, oh, that looks horrible. But if I really wanted to, I'd probably mix it a little bit just to bring down sort of the warm yellow tones. I'd probably mix it with a paler, slightly more neutral or pink foundation. I might try and see if they have 100N at some point just to see if that's any lighter and any more neutral. This is supposed to be a cool tone. I really don't find that it is. However, a lot of people have been saying that a lot of the shades in the line run more pink toned. So if you're very yellow, then that might be something to keep in mind that this line may not have a proper undertone for you. But it is a really beautiful foundation. I don't smell it like I did with the Stellar foundation. I found like maybe it interacted with my body chemistry, my skin chemistry, and just left a little bit of an odd smell. This one, I'm not noticing that. And it wears really nicely throughout the day, and I really enjoy it. Hopefully, more of the shades will become available in stores so you don't have to guess your shade. You're able to play around with it a little bit, swatch it, and see if it's right for you. And I'll probably try and link a couple other videos below since it is a newer foundation, just so you can see different skin types and skin tones. Try it out. So let me know what you think of this foundation, if you tried it or if you're looking forward to trying it. I'd love to hear from you. As always, I'll leave all of my makeup information down below. I am going to have a tutorial coming soon, so you'll know what is going on with the two-toned eye look here. And I'll also have links to my other Instagram and Facebook. Everything will be down below. If you want to subscribe, I'd love that. And if you don't want to, that's okay. I hope you have a wonderful evening or morning, wherever you are. And I'll see you soon. Bye, everyone.